In this tutorial, I'm going to go over the theory and purpose of the .scene file relating to the Ogre 3D engine and the LFA scene manager. So what is a .scene? A .scene file is simply an XML file that contains the positions of your objects in the world and attributes of those objects. If you aren't familiar with XML, it's basically just a text file that describes a hierarchy of things with names and attributes, nothing more. So what's the point? The .scene is the easiest way that you can position objects in Ogre instead of manually placing them in C++ code. It's much better to have the C++ parse in the .scene XML and dynamically position everything in your world by using the data. Hopefully it's obvious why the .scene is much more flexible. In the wiki, there are several .scene parsers to get you started. You and your programmers will have to customize it for your own needs. There's almost always going to be some type of specialized data that you're going to want to read in to your application. And as I go on, I'll show you how the LFA tools are actually designed to help you with that. The LFA tools will export a .scene for you from your Maya scene. Only Maya nodes that have been tagged for export will be represented in the .scene. Anything that wasn't tagged will be totally ignored by the LFA tools. So let's tag everything in our scene for export. If you ever want to see how a particular object is going to export into .scene, you can select it and go to Tools, Info, and List .scene of Selected, and it will show you exactly how that object will export into the .scene. You can even see how your entire scene will export if you select nothing and run the same command. And here we are, here's the entire .scene. And as you can see, it's the exact same thing as if I were to export my .scene right now and open up the .scene. It matches exactly what is printed out here. So let's take a look at some of the .scene data. Here you can see the hierarchy just like it is in Maya. If we made changes to the hierarchy here, it will nest accordingly in the .scene. You can see that right here. Something else I want to point out to you here is how in the .scene for every mesh, you have a node and an entity. Here's the node and here's the entity. The node contains position, rotation, and scale information, transforms. And then underneath the node you have the entity, which details what model to actually use. Here you can see the file, the mesh file. And at this point, anyone familiar with Maya will be noticing that Maya works exactly the same way internally. If you open up your hypergraph and tell it to show shape nodes, you go here, display shape nodes, you'll notice that for every mesh, you have a transform node on top, which is basically a modifier for the shape node, which is where the actual vert positions, normals, UVs, etc. are stored. So the LFA tools translate that relationship for you into the .scene when it exports it from Maya, the node and the entity. So to conclude this tutorial about .scene theory, I want to reiterate that exporting this data in itself won't make your application use any of it. You need to make sure that once this XML is exported, that it's loaded into your application and that in your C++ code you have a .scene parser, a serializer, that actually implements this data if you want it to do anything. So the .scene isn't like a .material in that it's automatically parsed and used by Ogre. You have to parse your own .scene. And like I said, there's some serializers in the wiki to help you get started on that part of it. So I'm really talking about a two-part pipeline. The output from the content creation software, Maya, exporting the .scene, which I'm detailing in this tutorial, and the second part, which is reading in the .scene and implementing the data inside of it, which I'm not covering in these tutorials, and I'm pointing you to the wiki about it. So the .scene isn't really a part of Ogre per se, it's just a common pipeline or method that a lot of Ogre users adhere to for interoperability. But you could design and export your own format and read it in, but why would you do that when there's already a pipeline in place? Another thing you could do as an alternative would be to write and maintain your own WYSIWYG editor, or like Unity or Unreal 3, that type of thing. But even if you have the resources to make such a tool, it may or may not even be the best option depending on your project. In fact, there are several editors like this available from other users if you search the forums. But for any artists who may be new to developing in real-time apps, the pipeline of the dot scene is not specific to the Ogre engine. Exporting object positions to a data file and reading that in is a very common method for game development in general. I've shipped at least one iPhone game and at least four PS2 titles that use the same exact method for getting things into the game. And really, in general, I prefer this method more than an in-game editor because it's fundamentally simpler. However, the argument of using content creation software as editor versus writing an in-game editor, pros and cons, is kind of a philosophical debate, and I'll leave it at that. So hopefully you have a good understanding of .scene now, and in the next .scene tutorials, I'll show you how to control what exports into the .scene in practice.